me receive inspiration for you. Let me receive revelation, Lord, from above to speak to your children. Father, bless me with all trance, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, O God, for great knowledge, advanced wisdom, advanced understanding. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, I disappear so that you appear in your children's life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, the word that is coming today, may he bless your people.
Amen.
May he bless your people.
Amen.
Let them open their heart to receive and understand your word this hour.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
Amen.
In the name of the Son,
Amen.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
For in Jesus' precious Christ's name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Today, I entitled a message, Church is like hospitals. Hallelujah. Churches is like what? Like hospitals. Yeah. That is churches. God have chosen his pastors. God also have giving knowledge to his daughters. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You believe it or not, God also have chosen daughters. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because in the book of Exodus or Numbers, we study it that when the people of God, when they are sick or whatever that happened to them, they will go to the priests. The priest will examine them. To see their feet.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we start from the beginning. Then there were no physical daughter. So the priests of God were teaching and they were also taking the space of daughter as well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So today, many people don't know this, that churches are also like hospitals. That is just the truth. Because when you are sick, you go to what? You call your GP. We have different kinds of doctors. We have also different kinds of pastors. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is different doctors, there is different what? Pastors. Praise God.
Amen.
Many doctors, like your GP now, cannot do surgery for you. Is that not true?
Mm-hmm.
When you are sick, now you call your GP. Then your GP will invite you to come. He will examine you, he will tell you what is wrong with you. Sometimes he's the one to check your high blood pressure or whatever, or your sugar, we do all those one first. So when he see that, oh, this is more than him, he will send you to what? To specialists. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will send you what? To specialists. So that is also the fee of pastors. Pastors also, they have prophets. They have evangelists, they have teachers, they have pastors, they have apostles. So that is what Jesus Christ, this is Jesus Christ himself, chose this fivefold ministry also to himself. In the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 to 12, I read. The Bible says, so Jesus himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the what? The evangelists, the pastors, and the teachers. To equip his people for works of his service so that the body of Christ may be what? Built up. Praise God.
Amen.
So, church also is like what? Hospitals. That's why you see sometimes God leads people to church for a reason.
Yeah.
Not because when they come you will just be happy you will have members. There is a purpose God has bring that person. Because we are going to read Corinthians first to see God himself are giving us different gifts to people. Different what? Different gifts to his children. So when people of God, when they are going through stress, sometimes some of them that have been in the hospital and the whatever, the specialist, maybe they have been to their GP, their GP has sent them to therapy, to any kinds of specialists that specialize in that case, and maybe it's not helping. So God himself will lead that person to his church because maybe that person needs spiritual attention.
Yes.
Are you getting it? So maybe that person needs spiritual what? Attention. to pray for that person, to lay hand on that person. You see, because by the laying hand of, by your laying hand, the sickness or whatever we want will disappear, will go. And most of the time, God sent them for a reason, to just come so that they will be what?
Healed.
They will be healed. And you pray for them, is the purpose of God, because that is His will, lead them there. So when they, maybe they are healed, then we go back to where they come from, because they have pastors. Let me tell you, in the book of Jeremiah, God Himself said to Jeremiah, Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15, He said, I will give you pastors according to my heart, which will feed you with knowledge and what? Understanding. Are you seeing it? God has given you a pastor according to what? To His own heart, that will feed you with knowledge and understanding. Some people may come to the church to receive their healing, but in there, after that, God will touch their heart to stay in that church. Because why? Maybe there is something God is doing in their life. Are you saying it? Because maybe God wants them to have understanding and knowledge. They will give them pastors after what? His heart. Like our brother Dana, he came here because God wants him to come. Are you saying it? He has a pastor. But because he is faithful to God and God leads him to come here, and he also called his pastor that is here in another church and he wants to stay there. And the pastor called me to release him from me. Are you seeing it? I'm talking about you. When you finish later, will you come to me? So the pastor released him from me. He's a Nigerian pastor. If he's a pastor's not, they will be fighting for what? After all I've done for you, just left my church like that. They will be using witchcraft, using so many things to fight that person. But many pastors have missed it. And many flocks also, they have missed it. Because when God sends you to a church, it's not by a mistake. He sends you for His own purpose. That's why I said church is like hospital. So people may come now, they will just receive their healing. That is the reason God has sent them there. Then we go. Some people will come, they will receive their breakthrough, because why? Their breakthrough is in that church. After they get it, they will go. But some will come, go after they receive it, God will still ask them to stay. Because why? That is where they will receive. That pastor, God has put something upon that pastor to feed you with. Are you seeing it? Because that pastor is going to feed you with the knowledge of God and the wisdom of God, so that you will grow. So that you will know the God you are what?
Serving.
You are serving.
Amen.
So that's why it's a dangerous thing to insult pastors. If you don't like pastor, don't sit under their canopy. Don't sit under them, because why? You are bringing insult on yourself. Because maybe that pastor is not your pastor, and you are sitting there bitter, angry about him or her, because he's not doing what you want her to do, or what you want him to do. Because what you want him or her to do, remember, you are not the one that put that pastor there. Everybody has their own styles of doing things. Maybe that is the pastor's own style, the way he's doing something, and maybe you don't like it. You are bitter, you are angry, you are talking, speaking here about that pastor. You are bringing curse on yourself. So what you need to do as a children of God, if you know that that pastor maybe is too small for you, or you are too big, or you don't want to stay under that pastor, pray that God should what? Should show you your pastor. Everybody have what? His pastor. Because you will stay there for 100 years, you will know what? You will not receive. And God also may also give you that pastor, but because of pride, of one thing you think that, I pray that no pastor will lack. Are you saying it? Because lack also can make people of God to lose their blessing for that pastor. Because we know when pastor is lacking, people will think that their anointing has run dry. Are you not? That is just the truth. Because people will think that that pastor longer, he don't have anointing again. The anointing is not there. They will start insulting that pastor. They will start placing curse on that pastor. Or maybe the church is not growing. Then it will discourage them. They will think that, oh, God has left that pastor. No. That pastor has God. If only God open your eyes to see the oil upon that pastor, you will not look at the lack of what is going on the pastor's life. You will appreciate that oil, because it's the oil upon that person that will bless you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Why am I saying this? Elisha was sick. But in his sick bed, people see a sick person. Although Elisha was sick, we still pray for sick person receive healing. No, because people don't understand. They insult pastor because of one thing, they despise pastor. No. I wish those people not that, that if he's a prophet, why he cannot pray for himself to him? It's me he want to come and pray for. He will die like rats. Because the sickness did not mean that God is not with Elisha. Even Apostle Paul, he said, 3 times I pleaded with the Lord. The Lord said, my grace is sufficient for you. But the Apostle Paul must still do his mission, what God has called him to do. A lot of people, a lot of Lord, they are sitting on that cross because what? The Bible says, you know, when we are telling this message, I use this on Sunday, but people will think I'm begging, mostly people that are cursing pastors. Don't join them. When you're on Facebook, you see they are placing curse on pastor. Nobody is perfect. Leave them, run away from your life. Because the pastor may do something out of flesh, he will still go and meet his father. Remember, the Bible said the judgment of pastor will be greater.
Yeah.
Not you pointing finger on them. No matter what they have done wrong, leave them to their father will deal with them. Then you will be judging them, placing a finger of accusation for someone you are not ordained. For some Bible tell Elijah, God let us know, not Elijah, Jeremiah. The Bible said, in your mother's womb, I have ordained you as my prophet. Are you seeing it? So such person, do you see the way people of Israel were? Because Jeremiah was also young when God called him. He said, how am I going to speak to these people? God said, God touched his mouth and put his word in Jeremiah's mouth to speak to the people. Jeremiah is a weeping prophet, which everyone knows, because why they despise him. Because if the word of God is burning inside him, whatever God gives, he will not see, even though the chief priest or whatever, like Jesus Christ, he speaks by the authority of God. No, by his own authority. So all those the people of Israel, meaning the leaders or the priests, they were so bitter about him the way they were also bitter about Jesus. But because the word of God is on their lips, if as I'm speaking now, what God is speaking through me, are you seeing it? So whatever I am saying, I'm not saying it by my authority, because why? It's about the authority of God. That's why I always pray, connect with God, so that God will speak what is in his mind through me. Because when I'm here, say, today let me come and give them. I will also, what? Carry curse away, because why? I want to curse the children of God. That one also want to come and serve God, because they will not come to the house of God. I will hurt their flesh. I will hurt them. Put more sorrow inside them so that they will go. But when they cry to their father also, what will happen? God will also answer.
Yeah.
So we should be careful the way we pass judgment, the way we do things, the way we point finger to kill pastors. Some of the flocks also, they are the ones that set their pastor out. Because when, you know, when pastor is so confused, so discouraged, not all pastor that have this confidence. When my father in the Lord came here last time, that is what he said. He said, one thing you admire about me, I'm so determined. No matter how tough it is, I will not give up. I'm someone, I don't give up. Even though you throw me inside hole, because I know I am a star seed, I am a seed, I will surely grow back. No matter how you try to bury me, I will grow back. Because the Bible said, no weapon shall form against us, shall what? Shall prosper. Are you seeing it? He said, if it's some of them, pastor, they will pack their thing, they will close up, because why? They cannot carry on. Time in my life, I preach to empty chairs. Nobody's in the church. I don't care. I don't bother. But the worst thing is that the people that God have given to you, if they don't have this understanding, the devil will enter them. They will be draining your oil. At the end, after the devil has used it to dry that oil, you yourself will still be saying that pastor doesn't know what he's doing. Not every pastor, God, you can drain his oil anyway. Just say the oil may not work for you, because why? You are touched. That oil. Are you seeing it? But it doesn't mean that when somebody that among that oil of God, the oil will also not work for that person. Because you may despise the oil, but whoever that God sent, like that white man on Sunday, God sent him here. I tell Minister, you should not worry, because as he, God sent me, thank God that I'm the one that was doing the prayer. So the God sent me here. God let me understand. I prayed for him. I prayed because he needed healing. Because it was God sent him for a reason and for his purpose.
Yeah.
Are you seeing it? And if God wants it to come again, he will come back. He will come back. He starting to come back, he will also go to where? His church. Because why? The purpose God has sent here is to receive his healing. Your people that also buy ticket to Africa to go and meet pastors in Africa, are you living there?
No.
You go there because you want to go and receive. Then when you receive your blessing, you also come back. If the church you go, if it's from God, you also come back to your church because you are not going to stay there. Even some people now in Nigeria, they have their church. Maybe when they are sick, they will go to Pastor TB Joshua Church. After they receive their healing, some of them will still stay there. Some of them will go back to their church because church is like hospital.
Yeah.
Are you seeing it? Because when you are sick, now when your doctor examines you, because the pastor called me, understand that, okay, this is the field of this pastor. Okay, you can deal with that kind of case. Like releasing for you. Are you seeing it? So that is the thing that people don't understand. They place insult on pastor, they insult pastor. And may also know, God may also lead you to another pastor that have the grace that pastor carry. Are you seeing it? So that there is reason God lead you there. But it doesn't mean that pastor will watch over your soul. Are you seeing it? But if God wants you also to stay in that church, God will give the pastor grace to watch over what? Your soul. The Bible said, when I was talking before, that when you see any page that are insulting pastors, please run away. Because you never know if these pastors, they are really from God. Have you seen it? Because you know, sometimes the real one, if you want to taste sweet banana, now some banana that will really taste good, when you look at the skin, you don't want to eat that banana because the skin is dirty. It looks brown, it looks somehow. But when you open that banana, you will see inside is very beautiful and it tastes good. But people these days, they clap hands for those that is making it. They want to follow them. Pastor God has chosen, given to you. You despise that pastor. You despise that anointing. You are pursuing another pastor. And maybe that pastor don't even have the grace. What it takes to deliver you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Never insult any pastor. No matter what, no matter how you despise them. If you don't appreciate them, if you know they are too small, or you don't respect their anointing, it's better for you to just leave that church. Don't stay in that church because nothing good will come from that pastor. Because already the anointing will not be attracted to you. Because even though you see as I'm speaking now, the angel of God is here with me. Are you seeing it? I said it last time. Anytime I'm in trouble, my pastor is gone, because God sent me to that pastor. But the devil know that is the church I will grow. And that is the church I will become whom God wants me to be. Devil also sent somebody with me to that church to discourage me. He was a friend. I said it before. So what to discourage me will be gossiping about that pastor to me. And this pastor never done me anything. He's a lovely pastor, but I don't know where this guy is getting that information from. To discourage my heart about the pastor God has chosen for me. To hate that pastor for no reason. Well, it was not her, it was devil. Because devil were after me. Are you seeing it? And the pastor they were insulting, the pastor were not the target. It's just me because I'm going to be filled in that church. And discover what? My gift. So the target were me. Not the pastor you were gossiping. Not me. Me that they were discouraging. Me we are the target to cut off. To uproot away from that church. Why? So that I will not discover what? My purpose. This Bible verse in the book of Psalm. Psalm is for everybody. The other one, he said, Psalm 105:15. He said, do not touch my anointed ones, meaning everybody anointed by God. Are you seeing it? Don't touch. That's why I said, yeah, now because you are a chosen one of God, you are a flock of God. God has anointed you. I should not use my mouth to touch you.
Yeah.
I can only preach what God put in my mouth to what? To tell you. Because when I touch you with my mouth, I will pay dearly for it.
Yeah.
Are you seeing it? Then he now said, don't do my prophet no harm. Are you seeing it? Don't what? Do my prophet no harm. Because what you are saying concerning the prophet of God, you are harming him and drilling the oil from them. You are harming them, but you don't know. And it's a great price for that. I must teach this truth because sometimes pastors may not teach you this because they are afraid they will not lose members. I prefer to lose you than you go, but your soul will be saved. Are you hearing me? You may be get angry and say, I will not come to that church again. It doesn't matter. Because my whole purpose is to whistle to God, not to carry crowd, we all go to hell. That is not my calling. My calling is your soul to be saved. Are you seeing it? That's why no matter the pains. Our Sunday school teacher said one thing. He said, Moses loved his people. Do you know what Moses passed through? Moses was no other prophet that lay curse. No. Like Jeremiah, now when God sent the message, when he tell you and you make him cry, we lay curse on you. He give you back direct. Are you seeing it? Is it Elisha or Elijah? And just mention all those prophets. It's only Jesus Christ that always say, Father, forgive them because they don't know what they are doing. Moses never, he loved his people. He's only someone, the people of Quran, that was contenting with the oil of Moses. They provoked Moses to anger. That is the only people God said, Moses said, if I be a servant of God, if these people die a natural death, I will know I'm not from God. That is the only way you see Moses lay a curse and instantly it will happen. But other prophets, when you offend them, they destroy you instantly. Praise God. Hallelujah. The Bible said by a prophet, Israel, you are delivered. By a prophet, Israel, you are preserved. Praise God.
Amen.
By the prophet of God, any pastor of his heart that he has given to you, you just need to pray. It doesn't matter how that pastor look like. I mentioned one thing before. For you to know, don't despise anybody. Don't look down on anybody. You see that banana now in your house, maybe you just buy a new one, you put them there. Your eye is attracted to that one you just buy because it's beautiful, it's fresh. So all those ones that have dots, you just say, I bet this one don't take. But if you open them, when you taste them, you will know how sweet it is. Never look down on anybody. Because you never know tomorrow. Tomorrow, that person you look down on, he may be your deliverer, your savior. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Even God also said in the book of Hebrews, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 17 said, he said, obey your leaders and submit to them, for they are keeping watching over your soul. Are you seeing it? Your pastor, they are keeping watching over your soul. You may be sleeping. Your pastor is awake, praying for your soul every day. Are you seeing it? Praying for what? Your soul every day. They are keeping watching over your soul. Because why? That is their duty for you. He said, as then whom we have to give an account. If I'm watching over your soul, I must give account for your soul. Because why? God give you to me to watch, to be what you want your, to watch over your soul. You will see. Sometimes you may be in danger. You will just see your pastor face. Like long time ago, Minister, did you say about 13, 15 years ago, Minister John had a revelation. He said in that vision, where somebody want to kill was struggle. Suddenly, see, I appear with white, with a sword, and defeat that person. For me, that time, I'm a Christian. So I now went to my pastor. I tell that revelation to my pastor because that is what I also seen in my pastor. Also, anytime in danger, we appear with a sword and white. My pastor says, it's not you, it's your angel. There is something about you concerning that woman. Because your angel, because you love her so much, because of the love you have in her, your angel is watching over her. That's why anything that wants to attack her, your angel will appear and defeat them. Are you seeing it? So sometimes God will give you people you don't know. You don't know. It's not by mistake you meet since you come across anybody in this world, there is a reason for that. There is a purpose for everything. But sometimes we don't know, Satan will cause deep conflicts, deep confusion to cut you away from your destiny. Because what? They will give accounts. If I'm going to give accounts concerning your soul, if God take me home today, he said, all this luck you have given to me, come and give account. It's what you do, I will give. I will not go and give account to what you don't do. If you honor me, I will tell God you honor me. If you grieve my spirit, I will tell God you curse me, you grieve my spirit. It's what you do to me, I'm going to give. Hallelujah. I'm going to give. Because God also let you, he said, let them do this with joy and not with groaning, not with grief. For that will be of no advantage for you. Are you saying it? So that's why I'm telling you that not your pastor don't have oil to deliver you. Not your pastor don't, it's not, the oil has suddenly disappeared. No, the oil is there. It's just still there. But how you treat the oil? Because if you treat the oil good, it will what? It's like a signal. When you treat the oil good, it will receive, it will connect to God immediately and be of good to you. But when you treat the oil bad, the oil also will grieve, because he said, grieve not the Holy Spirit in God inside us. Are you seeing it? So because when you grieve the spirit of your pastor, he may not speak to you, but also you have taken signal to God. So whatever you do to that oil, to that pastor, that is what he will give account. Sometimes even that pastor will lead, that will be praying for you, the angel that God have given to guide, to be going to a mission, will say, Lila, I'm not going. The angel is watching. In Psalm 91, he said, I will give my angel to watch over you, to go with you wherever you go. Angel is watching over us. And your pastor angel is angel God that assigned. Everybody have his personal angel. But there is special angel God that assigned to watch over the pastor's flocks, the sheep God has given, so that wolf will not catch them suddenly. No matter how that pastor will pray because of the Lord, the angel will refuse to go. Why the angel will go? He will not go. The pastor may not hear what you said, because why? It's in flesh. But the angel, no. He knows everything. He will not go. No matter how the pastor call heaven, John sweats, he will sweat. Blood will be coming the way we're coming from Jesus Christ. The angel will not go. Because why? He hears everything you have said. Are you seeing it? And open your eyes today. Not because of your soul. So that number one, you will not cost any pastor. Do your pastor, social media pastor, when you see where they are placing calls, run away. Please, just go. Don't add to it. Don't add. You know why? You may not know. You may think I beg. You see, there is karma. It doesn't matter how long. There is karma in this world. The universe must visit us according to our deed. We may do something today. We will think, I beg, that. No. Apostle Suleiman was saying, he said, people, we said, I beg, I cover myself, nothing they happen for with the blood of Jesus Christ. He said, remember those that have died yesterday, they also cover themselves with the blood of Jesus. Talkless you that don't even take God seriously. Be careful, my dear sister. Be careful. I know everybody is going to die one way or the other, but where are you going? How are you going to stand in your maker? His presence, when he opened the fire, how you are useless, rubbishing his servant that he have chosen. You are not the one that chose them. Jesus Christ himself chose these people. You don't respect them, you don't like them, don't speak about them. Leave their church or leave their pages. It's better for your soul. Because you are going to pay dearly for it. Not only your pastor, any pastor you are ever insulted, you are going to pay for it. Because why? Jesus himself called this fivefold ministry. God called the priests and the prophets. Are you seeing it? But Jesus Christ said to equip his body so that we will take care of his flocks. Then he called this fivefold ministry to himself. How will you know the one that is from God and the one that is for the devil? Huh? Jesus Christ, let us know, saying even the last day, even the elect may be what? May be deceived. Because you don't know. Because the wrong, the wicked one also may disguise themselves to be like the angel of light. The one you think is the angel of light, he may be the devil's servant. The wolf inside, covered himself with sheep clothing. How did you know? That's why you don't need to insult anyone. If you don't like them, don't watch them. Just go away. Praise God.
Amen.
It's for your own soul and for your own generation to come. Remember, most of our children these days, you know, most of them, you were saying something today that in Africa we have fire to serve God. Even you people, a lot of people that have come to Africa, how many people still have that zeal? Talk like the children you gave birth to, yeah. Please, if you don't love your soul, love the soul of your children. Because they may not know. Don't think they're in Europe. There is a lot of people in Europe. They're born there, even the white, their life is so miserable. Because of demons. There is demons. After I prayed for that white man on Sunday, do you know the giant, the demon giant that came to me? To bet with me, there is demons. We are taking. God is with us. We are fighting demons. I am fighting my own demons. Fighting your own demons. You will still be insulting me. No, it didn't turn out that way. Are you seeing it? Did you know the demons? That demon is a giant. The giant from the outside to come. What if you see this giant? If it's not the grace of God, I will run away. But the hand of God here with me, I bet with him. Because why? I carry the fire of God. Please, people of God, be careful the way you do things. Don't just do things anyhow. You may not care for it today. There is karma. It will surely come. The law of the universe, even though it's not even the law of God now, but this world, we all believe in karma. Whatever a man sow, he shall reap. It's so in the Bible. Yeah. Careful. If you don't value your soul, value the soul of your children. Don't bring a necessary battle for them to fight. A necessary battle for them to fight because of what you have done. A lot of us now, we are fighting battles. It's what our father have done. Our mother, where they are went to. Those demons is fighting us. Demons for our father's side, demons for our mother's side, demons for in-law's side. Even friends you meet on the way, their demons also is fighting you because you are encouraging them. We are living in the spirit world. This world is spiritual. Because you love your friend, the advice you are even giving to that friend, the demon that is don't want her to succeed or him to succeed is coming after you.
Yes.
Do you know many demons you are fighting against?
That's true.
No, because you know it's good to open you people's eyes to understand. Because not for me to just see things. It's just, I beg. I care for people's souls. Because why? That is my assignment. Praise God.
Amen.
Be careful the way you do things. Not just for your sake. Because some people, they are destined to go to hell, no matter how it is, like Judah. Because someone must betray Jesus Christ. Because that was the purpose of Christ, that someone will betray him. A man or so will suffer so many things. Are you saying it? But fortunately, Judah was the one that sold him out. Joseph, someone must betray somebody. But must still be you. Must still be you that Satan will enter to push that person to his glorious destiny. I always pray, may God not allow Satan to use me to be what? Some a destiny killer. Because if the person knows how to fight, and if he's choosing one, he cannot die. Because seed don't die. No matter how you try to bury them, seed cannot die. Go and bury them inside of them. We find a way to grow out. So that's why you need to prefer, may I not be a victim that Satan will use to try to bury a seed, a choosing one. Because they cannot die. when they finally succeed, how are you going to look them? How are you going to stand before them? Because you allow devil to use you. No, it's truth. Praise God. Imagine the way the children of Jacob, Joseph's brothers, the way they allow Satan to use them against Joseph. Is that not truth? They tried to bury him, but Joseph refused to die. Is that not truth? After his brother tried to bury him, brother did not succeed. Where he think, oh, here is my, if I am God, I'll thank God. Oh, now after all I went through my people's hand, now God are bringing me to a good place. The wife of the man pulled the Satan and tied that woman to throw him inside prison. That boy have not done nobody anyhow. But just because he's a star, a seed to set his people free, Satan set eyes on him. So he tried everything by all means to destroy him. His brother were thinking they are destroying him, and they were destroying their destiny, because that were their destiny helper. God has sent to him, to them, but they never realized it. They try, because Satan were using them, not with their self, not with their senses, but Satan entered them. After that, Joseph is thrown to prison without no offense. What is Joseph's offense? I said it last 2 weeks only. I said, my pastor, that man is a lovely man. What is the offense of that pastor? How could my friend, I don't even know how he's getting the information, that hatred where he's coming from, to discourage me about my pastor. But I refuse to be discouraged. And my pastor warned her seriously. I don't even know how my pastor know about it. He warned her seriously that she should be careful. Only one word he told me, Jessica, be careful. Before my pastor called her to warn her inside, we were coming to join. This, we were the pastor topic. He was discouraging me, condemning the pastor. Pastor warned her, she should be careful. Do you know that the pastor still calls her? You know, the pastor still cost her everything she received in that church. God withdrew it back. But today, she is the best friend of the pastor. Yeah. After she almost destroyed me. No, we should be careful the way we do things. Because God still make her to submit under that pastor. Because everything she got, God withdrew her back. The only thing I stand said no, because when she were pregnant, you know, I told her, I pray for her. I called her, I pray for her that you will not do this NVI. I don't know what they call it. If I a year by now, you will be pregnant. And that same day, I called her in the morning, early in the morning at 6 o'clock. I pray with her. And we went to church. Then he was talking about God, there is confirmation. When she came to church, both of us came to church. My pastor also prayed for her. He lay hand on her stomach. He prayed for her. I pray in the morning. My pastor pray in the evening. So that child, devil, we are battling to take that child. I said, no. That child cannot die. Because I prayed. I know God answered my prayer. God used you to confirm it. Are you seeing it? You know what? It's not the pastor, because it's Satan. Satan will come, because you know that the girl don't have covering anymore. When you don't have covering anymore, Satan will come after you. Because why Satan is doing you, he wants your covering to turn back on you.
Yeah.
Because when you're not, because you may not believe, it doesn't matter. Are you seeing it? Because when your person that is covering you spiritually, when it turns back on you, Satan will come after you. Be careful. She may not have recovery anymore. I left her and I come to UK. She lost my contact. And the pastor, and she left that church. That is what I said. She left that church. He got to another church because he believed that I beg him. But he seen what they call torture. The house they give to her, they take all. The benefit, the good work she will have, they withdraw everything for her. She left with nothing. She went back to her Duro house. This is the person they give everything to. Don't think you have everything, all is finished. God can withdraw everything. He's God. Because the person that was praying for you, you were destroying that same person. So the pastor withdraw herself and me go. She doesn't have my contact. She will be begging one of our family friends, Mama Mercy, to give her my contact. I surprise the same pastor that she be a cousin is submit under that pastor. Now she have 4 boys. This is a woman that gave birth so late. She have what? For God that blessed her with what?
4 boys.
4 boys. God have given her back everything that we are taking back. Because she was so rude to the pastor. The pastor said she should come and apologize. She said, God forbid, we not do it. The pastor said, if I be on top of what, if I be a servant of God, whatever my prayer I've answered to you in this church, I take it back. Within 1 year, everything will cripple. That's why I said, not all pastor can just be taking things. Take it in. That's why you see some of them, they will die prematurely. Because why? They don't want to curse. Not like if they curse, God will not hear. But what is going to be their gain? Are you saying it? No gain. No. No gain. But to carry the mantle of Moses is not easy. You will be sick. You will have chronic pains. You will be depressed. You will be... I know what I'm saying. I'm telling you the truth. Because the pains you will endure is too much. Because why? You don't want to curse. Praise God.
Amen.
Because of time, may God bless you. I said we are going to pray, but we didn't pray again.
That's how we speak.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I cannot read it. I will still pray with you for 10 minutes. Because I want to pray with you people. Write this down, read it yourself. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 4 to 11. It's about different gifts God has given to people. So that we don't surprise when you just see somebody come to your church, your pastor pray for them, the other day you don't see them again. Don't be worried about that. Are you seeing it? Because church is like what? Like hospitals. Maybe God has sent them for a healing. Don't be worried about that. So the one God has sent to stay, they will come back and stay. Praise God.
Amen.
God sent people for a reason. If you know you love your pastor, respect your pastor, honor your pastor, because the oil will bless you. By the prophets, Israel were delivered. By the prophets, Israel will what?
Deliver.
Will preserve us all. Let's be on our feet. We are going to pray because of time. Let's just do it 5 or 10 minutes. Please pray seriously. Say, I cancel my name and the name of my family from the death register in the name of Jesus Christ. Anyone that registered my name, my family name, in the register of death, I cancel it. This hour, begin to pray. Open your mouth and pray. Cancel it, people. Begin to cancel. Don't take it seriously. Begin to cancel. We are in bad mouth now. Any man, any woman, answer the enemy that registered my name, my children's name, my family's name, the members' name in this church for the book of death. Jesus Christ. Father, I don't know how to bury anybody Jesus Christ, I come against every fire that is not fire of God, every strange fire that is tormenting us. I command that strange fire to destroy. I command that strange fire to destroy. May the fire of the Most High God destroy every strange fire in our life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let every strange fire be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you all. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Every time.
Blessed time.